Hello everyone, I'm Laura, Colorful Stitching Girl here on YouTube and on Instagram, and I'm back after, I don't know, 3-4 months. It's so good to be back. I'm doing really great. So yeah, in this video I will start with a little life update because of course a lot has been going on, and then I will first I will I've not forgotten the giveaway winner, so I will say who won, and I will show you some whips, and yeah, but first I just wanted to say I'm doing great, doing pretty good. When I was, I think, 38 weeks pregnant, I gave birth to my second son. It all went pretty well. He is born at home as I wanted to, and then after he was born, the placenta didn't come, so I had to go to the hospital, and they had to take it out with like a surgery, little surgery. And yeah, so that was a little that was a little bit unexpected, and yeah, not the way I wanted it to be. But and then with that surgery I lost quite a lot of blood, I think 2 liters, so yeah, that's quite some. So I really had to take it slow the first weeks, and yeah, you know, the first weeks were crazy because I was so tired, and yeah, and you have a newborn, so it was crazy. But I think I was in the hospital for only I think 1 day, and then I came home and got some medicine with me, and I think it took me 6 weeks, 6 or 7 weeks, to get back on my feet and to do just a little normal things like shopping for groceries and going outside with my older son and things like that. But yeah, now my son is 2 months old, and it's, yeah, he's doing great and I'm doing great. So for now we're all happy, and yeah, it's just a wonderful thing, I think, to be a mother of 2 sons. I will slide in a pic with my 2 sons, so you can see what they're so sweet together. My older son is really a sweet brother, and always asking where he is, and yeah, he's just, it's normal, it's like he's, yeah, it's cliche, but it's like it's never been any different. So very happy, little tired of course, but I'm a happy mom, and back on FlossTube as well, and so happy with that. And yeah, I'm saying a lot. I really have to get into things, and it's such a long time ago, so really have to get used to the filming stuff a little bit again, but it will be fine, forgive me. And yeah, I have some other thing I wanted to tell you. Something happened, it was in the last weeks of my pregnancy. Our dog, which I told you about a couple of times, our dog died. Yeah, he was old, so it was, he didn't suffer, and it was just, yeah, it went really fast because I was at home with my pregnant belly, and in the morning he was doing fine, and just, he was old, but he was just himself, and sleeping a bit and playing a bit, and he seemed fine. And then in the afternoon he didn't want to sit or to lay down anymore, and he was like really short of breath and not doing well. And my boyfriend, I stayed home with my son, And my boyfriend went to the vet and they took some echoes, and they saw a massive tumor near his heart. So yeah, we couldn't do any different than let him sleep in, because he couldn't get, yeah, they could maybe get him surgery, but he was so old he wouldn't survive the surgery. And it was just, they told us when we take the tumor out, there's such a big chance it's back in a few weeks. And we were like, no, we're not going to do that. We don't want him to suffer anymore. So we decided to let him go. But yeah, as you probably know, if you've seen some other videos of mine, he was quite old. He was almost 10, which is very old for an English bulldog. So he passed away, and I think 2 weeks later, or maybe 3 weeks later, I gave birth. And so we're busy with the baby and with the kids, of course. And yeah, we miss our dog, but for now we have two kids, Hensful and our cat, and for now it's fine. We miss him, of course, but because he was so old, we're okay with it. It was the best thing to do, to let him go, and he had such a great life with us and with a lot of people around him who loved him. So he had a great life. So very long introduction for me. So now onto the stitchy stuff. I have installed an app on my telephone to pick a winner, and the winner is Patricia Tabak, a Dutchie. So congratulations. I will comment on your comment on the last video, and then we will be in touch, and you can choose a hate pattern from the site. So Patricia, I don't know if you're watching this, or if you may be maybe you following me on Instagram, and then we have some contact there, but we will be fine. So that's the winner. And onto my whips. At first I have some non-hates, and then I have some hates I've worked on. In my pregnancy I have finished this. It was, last time you've seen this, it was almost finished. The only thing I had to do was like this little corner, this corner with the ducks, and I filled it up and I did the back stitching, and now it's finished. I only it's for weeks and weeks I have to put the name of my oldest son in the middle, in the water. But I don't like the letters by this which came with the kid so much. So I'm searching for other letters, and I found some, but now I really have to see if it's fitting, and that's the only thing I have to do, adding his name and birth date. But yeah, I love this. This is so sweet. And then I also, in my when I was still pregnant, I started a birth sampler thingy for my second son, and that I chose this one. This is a Bothy threads kit, because I wanted to do something with animals as well. So I started this in my pregnancy, and after a few days after giving birth, the sun was shining and I was feeling a little bit tired but better, and then my son was sleeping inside, and I sat in the garden working on this. It's a really easy kit to just grab, stitch a little bit and put it away. So for now that's great, and I'm not so far. This is how far I am. So yeah, it's sweet. I did some backstitching on the go. I love to do the backstitching because you really can see the animals. Yeah, I love this. I will go on holiday soon and then I will take this with me. And then, like last week, a friend of ours was with us and she was, for her firstborn, I made like a birth sampler kit. And they really liked it and they hang it on the wall, on the door of his room. And now she's almost due for her second kid. We don't know if it's a boy or a girl yet. And she was like, yeah, and she was telling about the room of her first and how my kid, my piece is hanging on the door. And I was like, oh, I really have to make, it wasn't in my plans, but I was like, I really have to make her another one just for her second kid. So she's due in a couple of weeks, so I'm a bit in a hurry, but it's fine. I chose this one. It's a Verfaco kit, Safari, it's called Safari. It's this one with the animals as well. It's so sweet. And it fits with the first one I made. The first one I made for her was like a slot hanging in a tree with a name and yeah, so the animal theme. So I started this week for her. Hope she likes it. And this is how far I am. This is really a piece. Yeah, it's fun and easy to stitch on. I made a zebra already and now I'm working on the elephant. And it's yeah, it's a sweet kid. So this is a bit of a priority for now. And it's really easy to grab and stitch a little bit on it. So yeah, easy one to stitch on. It's like a big count. It's 14 count, I think, so 2/1. So it's really easy to stitch on. Yeah, I love this. I know she will love this, so that were my non-hates. Now I will get into some hates I worked on. At first, yeah, I decided to do a new start because for my son. I started the reef when my first son was born, and I really liked to pick a new start for his birth. So I did, and it is a piece, I bought it in the sale, and it has been on my wish list for a very long time. And it's a very colorful piece and I just love it. So I've chosen Hot Air Balloon Sunrise by Lars Stewart. And I'm starting in this corner here. And I've only started for a little bit. But I love this, I love the colors on this. Yeah, just love this picture. And this is my little start. I did 2000 stitches. In this video I have no before pics because it's such a long time ago. I was like, I'm just showing what I worked on and showing some pieces. And then a lot of this video, so sorry. And then the next video I will do comparison pictures, but for now I'm just showing what I'm working on. So yeah, as you can see, this is the sky. The clouds, a little bit of clouds, and this is the start of the first balloon. Yeah, I really love this. I'm not stitching in pages anymore because here is the page line, and then it's just I'm making some balloon, I think, and then some sky around, and yeah, love this piece already. And this is on a 20 count, my favorite, 2/1. Yeah, I love this. Love this already. 2000 stitches in. And did I say, oh, pregnancy, I don't know if I said already, but this is a max color version, so 240 color something, don't know, just love it. Love to work on this. And then I've worked quite a lot on the reef. It's my focus piece. It's the piece I started for my first son. And yeah, I have it out of the Q-snap, so I can show you the whole thing. I love to show the whole thing. I mean, look at this. Oh my god, it's stunning. I can't believe how far I am. This is almost 20%. So yeah, I'm really proud about that. And last time you've seen this, there was a quite a big gap between here and the turtle. And I filled it up. I can show you a little bit closer. I filled this up, this whole area till the turtleneck. And then when I will be working again, I will go down to the bottom. That's like one page, I think 1.5 page, something like that. And then the second row of pages is done. Yeah, I did about 8,000 stitches since last time you've seen it. And it was a lot of coral here and blue. Filling up the blues. Look at this. I say it over and over again, but it's just so stunning. Love everything about this piece. And it's 20 count, so... And the max color version as well. 20 count, so when it will be finished one day, it will be difficult to frame, but I just love it. Wow. So proud of this. This is The Reef by John Enright. It's my focus piece for now. I really want to finish this one day, but when I'm going through all my whips, I really want to work on them all. So I don't know, for the couple of weeks for in the future, this will be my, I will go, I don't know, I will come to that later, to the plan stuff. But for now, it was my focus piece, and it's, yeah, I love it, love to work on this. So, and then I worked a little bit on Cosmic Marbles by Amy Stewart. I'm doing the regular version, and really glad I chose that on 20 count as well, 2/1. And I have a page finish, but I'm letting more and more go of the pages, because on this piece you just stitch marble by marble a little bit. So this here, something here is a page line, and it just makes no sense for me to stop here when the marble is stopping here. And so I'm staying a little bit within, I'm doing page by page, but when the marble is going over the page line, I will just go over the page line as well. And I have to say, all this green is not my favorite, so I'm really glad this page is done, because on this page there's more and more orange colors coming in. I can show you. Oh, I don't have it here. I have it. Wait. Because this is the piece. This is the mock-up. And I've started in this color, in this corner, I mean. And now I'm doing this page. And that has a lot of oranges in it and yellows. Oh. So, yeah, I'm glad I'm going I'm going to do something, some different than all the green. Yeah, really fun to work on this, because it has not so much confetti color blocks, and yeah. Fun piece to work at for me. Next, I worked also on peacock plumage, which is a very happy, one of my happy pieces to work on. It's this piece. This is the piece. And I've started in the right corner. So started on this corner and I've done a lot. And now I'm stitching a little bit of the neck. So yeah, you will see it's you can see it's peacock. For now it's just like I'm stitching art, but I still love this so much. I love the colors, I love the little patterns you have in it. Yeah, it's such a beautiful piece. And I'm stitching this one on 20 count as well. So it's really a happy piece for me. I did 1500 stitches in this area. So this is where the neck. So I've stitched this this to the neck. This is the neck of the peacock. And I did a lot of filling in. This was a lot of confetti here and here. Yeah, really confetti heavy. So I just picked the color and stitched it. And the bag is a mess because I'm going all over the place. But yeah, it's so beautiful. I love it. So I was thinking like maybe I will do some neck and then filling up to the neck or something like that. I can't show you the rest of the piece because it's all folded up in the queue snap. Look at this bag. I really don't care about the bag. It's messy, but it's a colorful mess and I love it. That's fine. So yeah, this is peacock plumage, the regular 2/1. By Sue Taylor. I'm going all over the place, but it's fine. I hope you don't mind. My brain is a little bit of a mess and I have to getting used to filming again. But yeah, that's fine. And then I worked on, for now, this is my last hat. I worked on African Mammals. This is a max color version by Ciro Marchetti. And it's a hat. This piece, it's not as colorful as I usually go for, but I love it. I love the animals and I think one of my sons will like this. So yeah, it's I started with the lion in the middle. And I did 2500 stitches on this. And I'm stitching this because I want to frame it someday. So I'm stitching this on 25 count, 2/110 stitch. And it's still in the queue snap, so I can't really show it to you. Oh, look at this. Beautiful, right? I stitched, last time you've seen it, there was a, here was a gap and the nose wasn't. I did a little bit of the nose, like the black outlining, but that's it. So this time I stitched the nose. I filled in the nose and I was filling in this part. So yeah, it's so confetti heavy, this one. But when I'm looking at this, it's really stunning. So yeah, next time, I don't know. I will probably, or I will work around this. Or I will start here on the top again and then making the manes and going down to his eye. Because then the lion is almost finished. Or almost, but yeah, it's really showing up. Oh, look at this. Oh, it's such a stunning. It's the details in this, the fur. It's stunning. The eyes and the nose. Yeah, it's so confetti heavy. But it's really worth it. But I'm not always in the mood to work on this. But yeah. It's beautiful, I think. Really proud. And I really want to, if I look at the picture, I can go two ways, but for now I really want to make this what is it, a cheetah? Cheetah. But yeah, there's still a long way to go from the eye till the nose of the cheetah. I don't know yet. I will just stitch whatever I like. That's all fine. I'm with all my hates for now. I'm really letting go of the pages in Pattern Keeper. I just put off the page lines and just stitching wherever I want to go, and not in the pages so much. So that's fine. This piece is now, I think, 7% something. Yeah, when I look at it, I'm like, it's so, I've done so much, but when I look in Pattern Keeper, always struggling with that, with my tablet. In Pattern Keeper, I thought I would show it. This is how far I am. So, yeah. And this is, I can see, 7.7%. So, quite a bit. But still a lot to go. Okay. Then I have a little bit of crocheting. And I will tell you about my plans. Because now I have two kids and I just know how many time, or how I don't have so much time, but I have. But first I wanted to show you one crochet thing, and that's this one. I finished this. Oh my god, it's so cute. It's so big. Yeah, it was a pain in the ass, this fabric. I mean, this fluffy stuff, you can see your stitches, and it was really getting me frustrated, but now it's done and I think it's so sweet. Yeah, wanted to show this. I'm proud of this. It's now in the box next to my baby, and yeah, really sweet. This is a llama. No, I don't have, I don't know, I haven't write it down, but It's a llama pattern by Durable. Don't know. Bought this at the Creado as a package, as a kit, I mean. So, made the kit. It's sweet. Yeah. Yep, wanted to show you. It's done. And my older son also likes it because it's so soft. So he's cuddling with it a lot. Okay, so last, I wanted to tell you about my plans, because I don't do any WIPCO or things, but I also want to work on different projects. And now when I'm looking at my projects, they're here on the floor and everywhere. I just want to stitch on them all and want to make some progress. And besides of my, I have my kids, my two kids, which I started this video. So the Ark sampler and the Jungle Safari sampler. This are my, the Safari sampler is now my, like my focus piece, because it's a gift for my friend. But other than that, I will for now on my phone, I have an app, and then you can put your projects in and it just picks a random picker. So it picks a project. So for now, I've decided to work on one project for a week, and then, or as long as I want to. So a week or a little bit less if I'm really done with a project. But and then I will let the app choose my next project, and I will work on whatever it chooses. So yeah, that's what I want to do. And I'm like, if I can film every 6 weeks, I have at least 6 different projects to show you, because I don't want to make a video every month and then just show you 3 things and then I'm done. So yeah, I really want to show you a little bit more than that. So I, for now, I think if I do make a video every 6 weeks, then I have 6 different projects to show you. So for now, that's the plan. It's now the beginning of June, so this month will maybe be a little bit different because this is the month of June is my last maternity leave month. I'm still free, not working. So, and then we will go on holiday twice. We will go with my parents for a week, and shortly after that we will go with our family, with the 4 of us. So, and then I won't take any hates with me, but I will take the kids with me. So I'm like, on my vacations I will work on the kids because I can take them easily with me, it's easy to work on. And then around my vacations I will work on some heaven and earth designs. So for now, maybe 6 weeks, I don't know yet if I will make a video half of July or maybe the beginning of August, because I just want to make a video when I have like at least 5 or 6 different projects with a little bit, with a fair amount of progress to show you. So my last video will probably be the end of July something, and then I'm working again, so I have to see how much time I have left when I'm working. Now I have a lot of time when both of my kids are sleeping, and in the evenings I can do some hobbying. But when I'm working again, yeah, I will work, will go back to work for 3 days a week, so I will have to see how that goes. But for now, that's still quite far away. I have 4 or 5 weeks left at home with my boys and going on vacation, so yeah, we will see how it goes. I really want to thank you for joining me, for listening to me. And my last video, I read the comments, but I didn't comment on any of things. And my good, how do you say it? My good intention for now, from now, will be I read the comments and I give them a heart, or I respond a little bit, because I really love how you watch me, comment me, how I have so much subscribers. It's insane and it's really appreciated. So wanted to end with that. I hope you're all doing well, that you're all enjoying some lovely weather. And I will see you again in a week of 6, I think. See you then. Bye bye.